actually taking a walk in this deserted car park. And you also notice that in the HDB block, right, you have a lot of cameras. Hope there's no camera around here. I mean, what did they do with the cameras in the car park?
In the next episode.
What did they do with the cameras in the car park? Did they actually review them when there's accident, or they just review them as they went on a timely basis?
On demand.
So basically, like,
people report a case or
an accident,
then they will pull out the footage. But then again, I don't think it's a 4K, right?
this is Full HD, so I'm not using a 4K. But I will do all my 4K videos with real stuff, like vlogs. I cannot afford to make a 4K because it's just too much data. But if you all would like to leave a comment,
want to see a better one, you can do that as
well. Yeah, I guess, but usually vlogs, you guys don't really want to see our face so clearly, right?
Yeah, that's basically the topic.
Let's talk about cameras on the cameras for this topic. So, are they really useful? Or is it just is it really useful, or it actually causes more problems?
Yeah, because people, when they're approaching junction, right, then they just slow down, and then
maybe just because of the camera,
right, subconsciously they will slow down,
and then traffic behind start to brake, then probably the third car or the fourth car behind will actually jam brake, and crash.
Chain reaction.
You call it a slinky effect. So as the first car slow down or check brake, the second car start to brake harder, and the third car brake even harder, and then the fourth car will actually have to do an emergency brake.
Oh yeah,
it's a sinking effect.
That's another point. From our point of view, if let's say you jam brake, then the car suddenly thought, why this guy jam brake?
And then you create unhappiness, and then they start to overtake each other, and brake accidents happens again, right?
Yeah.
But I thought it's a good and bad thing.
Yeah, double-edged sword.
Yeah, call it double-edged sword. Because maybe it's a bit overkill today. Because we really see a lot of cameras.
Too many
already.
So what should we do with them?
Paint the lens back.
Somebody did, right?
Yeah.
Right,
somebody right. And then was quite caught because while he was painting it.
Somebody.
The camera is looking what's that? Okay. The camera does not trigger this guy, not in Singapore, but he's trying to paint the camera black.
To block the lens,
Yes. But unfortunately, while he was painting it, the car sped over the traffic light and the camera
activated
flash for his face instead of the car. So he was caught.
That's like one in a million.
And you also notice that in the HDB block, right, you have a lot of cameras, especially in the lift lobbies and
basically almost everywhere.
Almost everywhere we have cameras. I find that it's actually a kind of a intrusion of privacy.
I mean, when you're coming back late, it helps.
Hey, what if you are kissing your girlfriend and then after you get caught? Wow, there's a burger, let's say there's a theft happening behind you.
Or maybe
the authorities start to take out this footage and saw you actually.
You're
married!
Wow!
Okay, that's a joke. This might be a scenario there are people who are actually very sensitive about cameras looking at them. So let us know if you really love cameras and traffic light, or you think it's really a necessity, or you think it's like overkill.
Just maybe
leave a comment.
Leave a comment.
And then we'll be working on a new video, which is. We have a crash! Yes, where's the drone? So did your drone actually survive?
Crash from the fifth level down.
In the next episode.